Let's see. Let's see what I got here next. Let me know.
What's going on, guys? It is your boy Rich coming back with another video. Obviously, it's about the TSX. From the title, you may know. We're gonna be going over some of the common issues with the TSX, some of the common problems I've had or I've seen in the Facebook groups everyone's asking questions about. Obviously, I got my trusty notes here. If you guys have any other inputs of issues that I've maybe missed or maybe you've had common issues with, feel free to drop them in the comments. If you like the video, leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't joined the Rich gang yet. There's a handful, you know, of problems with the TSX, just like any car. The source of my information is obviously, you know, from my own experience from my previous TSX and this one and Facebook groups and all that stuff. So, most common problems with the TSX. Start off, AC compressor is a general thing that goes after, I don't know, if you have aftermarket, it could fail whenever, to be honest. Like, it's a hit or miss. A lot of people go AutoZone or something or rebuild them. That's kind of like a general common issue. It's not really like a big deal. It's pretty easy fix. Power steering pump leaking, that's also another common issue with this. O-rings actually got recalled. Tends to leak through the hoses or from the inside of the seal. And that's one of the issues I've had with this. My power steering pump was leaking, so I just replaced the whole thing with the O-rings and all that fun stuff. Another thing related to the power steering, rack and pinion seems to kind of go out on people. Personally, haven't had that experience. I guess it kind of just blows out and doesn't really leak as the power steering pump does. I've seen plenty of full times of people talking about rack and pinion. Really, your only options are rebuilding your OEM one, getting like a rebuilt one, or getting like one of the ones from eBay that people get. They're pretty expensive OEM, so it's not really too fun of a job either. So you're gonna be coughing out quite a bit of dough. So another little problem with the TSX, the starters, they tend to go a little bit too. I had a problem with that on my last blue one where mine kind of went out. I was sitting there knocking it with a breaker bar for like a week and a half until it really didn't like start after knocking it. So after that, for like a week, I was sitting there pop starting it, you know, luckily on manual, so it was allowed me to do that. Almost got caught in some situations not be able to move. Luckily we'd be able to push it a little bit enough to get it going. All right, continuing on with the passenger side, tends to go out more with suspension related parts like the axle. That side tends to vibrate, especially with aftermarket axles. I don't know if it's like the inner joints and, you know, the angle, especially if you're lowered. For me too, I had an intermediate shaft go out on my last one, and that's kind of like an overlooked part. You could rebuild it with the bearing, whatever, or just buy a new one like I did. Related to the passenger side, but both sides, it's possible. The ball joints, if you don't check your suspension or you don't do it in time, you hear the squeaking or whatnot, you could have a moment of ka-chow. I had that on my last TSX, but my issue was got the job done and my brother forgot to put in the cotter pin, so that ended up blowing out. It was the driver's side, but more so the passenger side goes out for people. Again, just you gotta check your suspension parts, your ball joints and whatnot. That's all it really is to it. Another thing I forgot to mention was the alternator. Those tend to go out too. So the alternator, power steering pump, and starter. And the AC compressor. I guess all of them are kind of like common issues. General maintenance, they go out after so-and-so miles, you know. With the alternator, with acceleration, you start hearing the whine in the radio. The frequency, it's kind of weird. It's electrical related, so it kind of makes sense, obviously. If you have the 06 to 08 Acura TSX and you have any issues with your car, it's definitely the Bluetooth. It's definitely the Bluetooth, hands down. If you feel some shaking in your car, it's the Bluetooth. You know, you got to disconnect that because it's draining all your power from your car and it's making it all vibrate. Hope you guys don't think I'm serious. But yeah, if you guys are having actually like some draining issues where you're just driving it, it started or whatever, and you come back an hour later and it's dead, it could be the Bluetooth thing. That was my problem when I first got the car. It's on the side right here on the interior. That was easy fix and whatnot. And I just drove around to recharge the battery. Let's see, let's see what I got here next. That we don't need that. Off the top of my head, the control arm bolts, if you live somewhere in like a rusty area like New England or something like that, you're more than likely gonna have to seize control arm bolts, rear toe arm and camber arm bolts, which is not fun at all to deal with. So you're gonna have to chop them out or whatnot. Also with the TSX, what people tend to hate, first and second gear, clutch master cylinder, the delay valve, it's kind of just notchy and it makes you feel like you don't know how to drive a stick. First and second gear, you're just like so delayed, you know, hence the delay valve. What I did was buy the EM2. I bought the hybrid racing kit with the braided line and slave and whatever, and deleted the delay valve. Definitely faster shifting, smoother and whatnot. Old girl needs a clutch right now. I'm about to be ordering a Comp Stage 2 clutch, so with the lightweight flywheel, and I gotta get motor mounts. I feel like we kind of went over a lot of like the general issues that people tend to have. If I missed something, leave a comment, let me know. We'd love to hear what. You know, I love interacting with you guys. I'm always replying. I love the feedback. No, you hope I'm like, you know, your main go-to TSX content guy. I love the support, man. It brings me a lot of motivation. I really appreciate you guys. We're almost on the road to 2K. We've really been growing a lot. I just keep trying to do more and do better and up the quality and bring you guys more content. We're gonna keep upping our gear, different content. You never know, we may end up in like Florida or something and the vibes are gonna be way different. So if you guys are enjoying the TSX videos, drop a thumbs up, drop your ideas down below. I'm trying to do more and bring you guys what you want to see and what you guys want to know more about the TSX. Maybe I haven't been driving her too much lately. I need to do the clutch like I said before. It got really bad the other day if you watched the vlog. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Much love. I appreciate you guys greatly. If you guys shop at Hiroto, use our 5% off discount code RISH, all caps. Save some money, go shop, buy some parts, watch some videos of the TSX, and yeah, thank you.